So with 2020 almost over, I said, hey, let's take a look back at all of the sneakers that I've picked up over the 10 plus years that I've been into sneaker collecting. And I say we start off with the ones, starting off with my favorite sneaker of all time. This is the Air Jordan 1 in the bread colorway. I absolutely love this. I picked this up in 2016 at a local consignment store. Next up is the Air Jordan 1 Bloodline. I picked these up this year. I picked up 3 pairs of Air Jordan 1s this year, which is a really great thing. And I absolutely love this. And I think people will look back on this sneaker and think that they should have picked it up. It's not really a hyped Air Jordan 1, but given that it's the OG Chicago Bulls colorway, I think that people will love it. It's not an OG Air Jordan 1, obviously, but it's a black, white, and red Air Jordan 1. So I know people will love these. Next up is this shoe right here. This is the Air Jordan 1 Royal Toe. The Air Jordan 1 Royal Toe. And I haven't worn these that much this year, just because of the pandemic, just wasn't outside that much as I normally am. But this is a great shoe and a good consolation prize for the Air Jordan 1 Royals. I camped out for those when they came out back in, I think, 2014 or something like that, and I missed out on them. So this is another great shoe that I was able to pick up 6 years later. So I absolutely love these. And moving forward, we have the Air Jordan 1 Mocha. This is probably my favorite pickup of the year. It's so great. I'm big into earth tones, as you guys know. So getting a brown Air Jordan 1 is something that's really great. So it's the same sort of deal. It's sort of a consolation prize to the Travis Scott Air Jordan 1, but I absolutely love these, and I'm really glad that to have picked them up, and I'm glad you guys have been liking the videos that I've put out. So let's check out the Air Jordan 3. Okay, so let's check out the Air Jordan 3. I don't have any 2, so we're gonna skip ahead to the Air Jordan 3. This is, of course, the black cement color. This is from the Countdown pack. I absolutely love it, as you can imagine. The paint was cracking like hell, so I did a little bit of a custom video of me restoring the midsoles here, and you can check that out by going on my Instagram. But I absolutely love these, and I'm really glad to have these. These are a really classic shoe, so they're always perfect to have. Next up, in terms of OG Air Jordan 3s, is the True Blue colorway. This goes absolutely perfect with, you know, a pair of blue jeans and a white t-shirt. So that's what I wear a lot of outfits with these. These came with the Nike Air on the back, which is great. And these released back in, 2016. So these are in rough shape, and they're not aging very well, but it's just part of the game. And speaking of Air Jordan 3s that are aging well, we have the cool gray Air Jordan 3s that are re-retroing next year. Now, I picked these up from SneakerCon 2 years ago in 2018, and I absolutely love them. They are falling apart. The other pair is right here, and just the heels of them are just falling apart. But it released in 2006, so that's what happens when you get a shoe from 2006. That's you know, 18 years old, or you know, that kind of thing. So or 14 years old, sorry. So these are really great, and the quality on these is really, really nice. Now, to cap off the Air Jordan 3s before we go into the 4s, it is the wool Air Jordan 3s. These are perfect for winter time. That's basically the only time I really wear them. They're really warm, which is great for the Canadian winters, and I love how they have this almost aged looking sail colored midsole and outsole. These are almost indestructible, which is great, and which is why I pull them out in the snow and the rain and that kind of thing. So really cool shoe. One that I don't wear too often, just not that much hype around it, and it's just a pretty simple colorway, but some of the Air Jordan 4s I got, I wear them all the time. Okay, so the Air Jordan 4 is probably literally my most worn shoe of the year, probably second. I would say the Blazers are first, which we'll touch upon in just a minute, but I wear this shoe all the time. It just goes so well with a pair of black jeans, blue jeans, you name it. I absolutely love wearing these. Nike Air on the back, quality is good on them. They really did justice on this release, which came out about 2 years ago, and I did a how to style video on these, so you guys can go check that out if you'd like. And overall, it's just one shoe that I'm really, really glad to have. Which brings us to the next and final pair of Air Jordan 4s that I have. This is the white cement 4. This is a shoe that I picked up many, many years ago that you can tell by the coloring. This is when I started saving my money and being like, okay, like I'm really gonna collect shoes. So I think these came out in 2011. I really love this shoe. It's a great shoe to have. It is yellow ink, and the quality on this is absolutely terrible. So I'm really happy to have the shoe itself. Quality, not so good. Yellowing, a ton. I have coffee stains on the laces, but I kind of like them beat up. And that's kind of one of the trends nowadays with sneakers, right? Is wearing shoes that look like they're 100 years old. But either way, really glad to have these. So let's move into the fives. Two pairs of fives for you guys. We got the Firebird fives that I picked up this year for, I would say about like the most of my sneakerhead years. I didn't love this shoe. I preferred the Fire Red version with the black tongue, but for some reason, when The Last Dance came out and I saw these and I saw pictures of them, I was like, okay, this is a shoe that I really want. It was sort of like an impulse purchase off of The Last Dance. And I just, at that time, I was like, I want every OG colorway of every shoe, you know, every Jordan. So I went ahead and I picked these up and I absolutely love them. I'm so glad I picked them up. Totally changed my mind about the shoe, and you know, because of the pandemic, I haven't been wearing it a ton, but either way, this is something that I truly, truly love, and I'm really glad to have them. Nike on the back as well, so you really can't beat it. Now, another shoe, when I started working full-time, I was like, okay, like, let me start buying almost every release that was coming out at the time. This was back when these came out, so this is the black metallic Air Jordan 5, Nike Air on the back. Quality on this is really good. It's similar to the Fire Red 4s that just came out in terms of that, you know, that black nubuck. But I absolutely love these. Starting to yellow a bit, but ultimately they're still in, you know, decent condition. It's a shoe that I wear most of the time, and if I do, or some of the time rather, and if I do end up wearing them, I usually wear them with like a pair of black jeans, just because the tongue, you know, really, really pops. This is a very bulky shoe, as you can imagine, but it's one that's absolutely classic, and I'm really glad to have these. Okay, so it's time for the sixes. I picked these up a few years back, around 3 years ago, at a sneaker show. Shout out to Canada Got Soul. It was their Soul Exchange event. And I, what is there to say about these? So, such an amazing shoe. I absolutely love these. I do wear these often. There's something, I have an affinity towards black Air Jordans, which you guys will see in just a moment. The only thing is that this is, I got these for a great price, which is why I bought them. But the thing with this shoe is that the quality isn't the greatest on it. It's very stiff nubuck compared to the other two nubuck shoes that I was showing you guys just a moment. Also, as opposed to the Fire Red that they normally go with these, they put on the infrared. I know this is the infrared 6, but from what I understand, the OG colorway had a different shade of red. This is like pink. It's basically like black with like pink hits. But from afar, it almost looks like it's an orangey red kind of thing. So I like to actually pair this with a lot of like army or navy green colors, you know what I mean? And so that takes us into the Air Jordan 7. This is the Raptors colorway. Being from Toronto, obviously big Raptors fan, so it was important that I picked up this shoe, and it is really great. I think that the 7s are so slept on, and I don't know why. They're just not hyped. Just wait, wait, just wait until, you know, Virgil or someone does an Air Jordan 7 collaboration, and now they're all popular again. But hey, that's, I'm cool with that too. I actually would really love to see the Cardinal 7s re-release, but ultimately this is a great shoe. Great Raptors colorway. The 7s are very comfortable to wear too, so I think that they need to make more of these. This is, it's weird because this is a high top shoe, but it's not bulky. Like when you're wearing it, it doesn't feel super bulky, and it goes well with a lot of different fits, so I hope that they bring more of these out. Now, I did, for the sake of time, bring out some of my other Jordans, which would take us to the 11s. I don't have any 8s anymore, 9s, don't have 10s, don't have any more. So we'll take us to the black and the red Air Jordan 11, or the playoff 11s. I picked these up 2 years ago when they came out, and I really love them. Or last year, this was last December. So it's crazy, it's almost been a year since this release. I wear these often. They're great. I've done two different how to style videos, so I highly recommend you guys check those out. I really love styling the 11s, and this is sort of like the 11 season, right? So I'm really happy about that. Patent leather 11s are amazing, which then takes us to the Concords. I love this shoe. There's so many things I love about this shoe, but I just don't seem to wear it that often. And I don't know, I think it's because of the colorway. It sort of resonates with more of a summery type colorway. But either way, really glad to have these. which I've been saying a ton. I'm already recognizing the speech patterns here. But hey, this is such a great shoe, and all of these Jordans that I have, I'm just really thankful to own them and be able to afford them and share them with you guys. So, woo! I love me some 11. So let's check out some Nike Dunks, because I think we're done with Jordans for now. Okay, so I already lied to you guys. I got two more pairs of Air Jordan 1s. These are just sort of random shoes that I have. So this is the Air Jordan 1 KO that I picked up at Flight Club in New York in 2000 and I don't even remember, 2016, maybe 2015. I did a custom on these recently by aging the midsoles. You will probably won't be able to see it on camera, but if you're interested in the finished product of what it looks like to age your midsoles using candle dye, then you go check out my Instagram. This is the Canvas Air Jordan 1 for those that don't know. And then this is the Air Jordan 1 low top. I absolutely love these. I'm thinking about giving these away. So let me know, would you guys like to see a giveaway for this particular shoe? It's been worn, it's in great condition though, and it would be, of course, absolutely free. So just let me know if you guys wanna see that. But let's talk about Dunks, because those are probably my favorite pickups of the year. University St. John's Dunk right here. My girlfriend bought these for my birthday, so shout out to Nicole, really happy to own these. The quality on these is amazing, and of course Dunks are super popular this year. I did pick these up in August, so I didn't really get to wear them that much, just because it's winter here, and the summer ended, ends around, late September-ish. That's when things get a little bit warmer. Either way, really great colorway. Tiff Dunk Highs. This is one of the first sort of collectible Jordans. I bought these, take this in, so I bought these back in 2000. This was the year after I bought the KOs, so this was probably 2016 is when I bought these. And so I bought these in Flight Club for $250 US. Now I thought, like, yo, I'm paying a lot of money for this. Now they're, probably a $700-$800 shoe. Either way, really glad to have these. Tiffany Dunk Highs, Diamond Dunk Highs, just such a loud shoe. I don't wear these that much just because it's hard to sort of rock all the time. But when I do, it snaps necks, which I like. It starts a conversation, and ultimately, it's one of the more collectible Nike Dunk Highs, so I had to grab those faux show. Sorry, my chair is making a lot of noise. Next is this Air Jordan. This is the Nike Dunk SB. Low Pro in the Dusty Peach colorway. This is a really funky shoe, and I bought these just before the Nike Dunk hype sort of came. So I bought these for retail, walked into the store, bought them, no questions asked, no jumping through hoops and barrels. But I didn't know this was like going reselling for a lot of money. Not a lot, but like upwards of like $500. I was like kick flipping in these in the summertime, and now they're kind of a little bit banged up, but either way, it just sort of adds character. But I love the shoe a lot. So with that being said, I'm gonna show you a couple more Nikes that I have before we jump into the Adidas, Yeezys, and other brands like New Balance, for example. Okay, so let's kick it off with some Air Max. I got the Air Max 1 in the anniversary color, as well as the Air Max 90 in the infrared colorway. This isn't the one that released this year. This is from 2010. I got this. This was probably the best steal that I've ever bought. And they were generally used. I bought them at SneakerCon last year for $80, which is just insane. Really happy to have picked this one up. Just the quality on the 2010 pair was really great. It is like a half size down, so I gotta wear like finished kind of socks with them. And then for this one, I also bought this at SneakerCon the year prior. I bought these for $200, which is, I think, just below retail in Canada. And the only thing is that this one is a half size too big. So there's kind of like these little creases and little folds on them just because they're a little bit big. But either way, this is a shoe that I absolutely love. And for those that are interested in, Canadian sneaker culture, the Air Max 1 and just Air Maxes in general are super popular in Canada. Especially, you'll see people wearing them in the summertime. Toronto actually got their own Air Max 1 colorway, which is black and white. So, the city really, really loves this shoe right here. I love Air Maxes. I have more Air Maxes coming on the way. But either way, it's just a really great shoe, both of them, that I'm really happy to have. Next up are my probably two most worn sneakers of the year. These are Blazers. Guys, Blazers mean a lot to me. They sort of kicked off, you know, the year for me with a how to style video of this shoe right here, which you guys love. It has almost 300, I don't even remember how many views it has now. It's just hundreds of thousands of views, which I'm so grateful for. But either way, I love both of these shoes. I first got these ones and then I'm like, you know what? I need like the reverse colorway of them. So they all suede. These ones are all suede, these ones are leather. But either way, both of these shoes are really great. So happy to have them. And just the fact that I bought these in February when I went on a trip to South Beach, Florida, in Miami, I bought this at the Kith store. So I have a lot of memories, a lot of great memories with that shoe. So next I'm gonna show you guys some a little bit more obscure shoes that I have that you guys have never seen on the channel. And that is the Kyrie 1. I bought these when they first came out, back when all red shoes were really popular back in 2014. I was actually with like an ex-girlfriend at the time when I bought these, which is kind of funny. Either way, really happy to have these. I used to play basketball really quite often. This was back when I was still in university. We used to play pickup all the time. I've kept these for the simple purpose that if I ever pick up the hobby again, if I ever, you know, have to play ball or anything, then this is the shoe that I would wear. It's really great, and I just, the traction on it is insane. So, sorry, just reaching for some shoes right here. So next up is an Air Force One custom that I did in the summertime. This is the linen Air Force One custom that I did. So this was really fun time making these. The only thing is that the paint is starting to crack. They kind of look like shit now. And I kind of wish I had the all white Air Force Ones. But either way, the shoe isn't too expensive. So I know once the weather starts getting warmer, I'm gonna buy another pair. Next up is the VaporMax 2020. This shoe is a really technologically advanced shoe, which is really cool to me. Finish Line sent me these. We're collaborating on some videos, which is a bit of a sneak peek for you guys, but it's really happy that, you know, I'm starting to get some brand recognition, especially from a brand like Finish Line, which is insane. So some more details to come on that one, but either way, the VaporMax 2020 is just a really cool shoe. The fact that it tightens with this little loop here and then releases tension by pulling the tab is just really, really cool. So let's check out some Adidas, Puma, all other great stuff. Okay, so next up is the Yeezy 700. I bought these back in January, and when I got them, I was really like uncertain about them. They were a shoe that I wasn't used to wearing, very bulky. It was my first sort of dad shoe, but let me tell you something, holding these in hand, the details on them are insane, and I really love the 700 model. The only thing is that they're really expensive, so I'm very selective on which ones I buy. The only other colorway that I probably buy on these are like, you know, the Wave Runners, but those are really up in price now. But either way, I love this color too, the analog color. It's a nice beige color, which then takes us into another beige Adidas that I have, is the Ultra Boost. This shoe, the Bred 4, and the Blazers in the white colorway are probably my three most worn shoes of the year. Given it was quarantine, I was doing a lot of home workouts in my home gym in my garage, so I wear this shoe often just because it's so easy to wear and it's very comfortable. So this is another amazing shoe. I absolutely love these. I bought these 2 years ago, I think. Yeah, a year and a half ago. Either way, absolutely love Ultra Boost. That was my first pair of Ultra Boost, like a year and a half ago. So let me tell you something, love Ultra Boost, it's great. Okay, so time to talk about New Balance. I would say aside from Nike, Adidas, you know, my favorite, and Air Jordan, my favorite brand is probably New Balance. This is my only pair of New Balance, but let me tell you something, the quality that they, and craftsmanship that they put into their products is just insane. So given that fact, this is something that I absolutely love. I bought these in the summertime. I did a how to style video on them, and that's probably the best video that I've ever put together. So if you guys want to check out how to style the New Balance 997 and the New Balance 990, then I highly recommend that you check that video out. Love that one right there. Next, let's talk about some Puma kicks. So I really enjoy Puma. It's a great affordable sneakers. So if you guys are, hey, you know, what shoes can I get that that are under $100, under $200, then, you know, definitely check out Puma. This is the Future Rider. I absolutely love this shoe. The colors on it are insane, super comfortable to wear. And just, I love the combination of like this color, this shade of orange with the gray and the black and the blue hits. Really fire. I loved making this how to style video also. And this video that I made was a trend in my videos where I was like, okay, I need to add storytelling. I need to add like great details that will highly improve my videos. which then takes us to the Puma Ralph Sampson low top. So this is a great alternative to those who are a little bit want some difference between the triple white Air Force One. Tons of great details on these. This is a good menswear-esque shoe, so if you guys are into sort of more formal looks, then I highly recommend getting that one. And my latest Puma pickup, which is the second shoe that Finish Line had sent me, is this Puma RS Fast right here. This is another sort of dad kind of shoe, but it's really great. It has some nice heel counters right here, and just the details on them are really nice. They're comfortable too, so I'm excited to put these together in a how to style video also. So that about does it for the 2020 sneaker collection video. That's basically it. I have a couple other shoes that aren't really worth talking about, that are just beaters, just totally toast, not even in wearable condition anymore. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and have a great day. Peace.